Hey YouTube, if you have a Spectrum TV remote that looks like this, this video will be a quick guide on how to set it up, and I'm not going to really waste your time on it, so let's just get started. First section here of this video is going to be setting up, let's say, your television set, and then the second section will be like setting up a receiver, which is the same way. But I'll tell you the little secret as to how to assign the volume buttons to your receiver rather than your TV, because that's something I like to do, and the Spectrum Tech never does set it up that way for you for some reason. But let's get started, all right? So let's say like you want to do the auto method of setting up your TV. You're going to hold down the TV button and OK at the same time. When you do that, the light will go solid. Once that TV light's gone solid, you're just going to aim it at your TV and constantly hit that channel up button until the TV turns off. When it turns off, wait just like a second, hit power. If the TV doesn't go on, hit channel down, and then the TV may turn back on again. Then try hitting power again, and then if it turns back off, then hit the TV button. The reason why this channel up and down thing works is because think of it going through like a list inside. You just can't see it scrolling through a list, but it's scrolling through a bunch of codes. Now, there is another method to this. You can also use what's called a quick setup table. This is a little bit weird, and it doesn't always seem to work for some reason. It only works for some brands, but hey, let's go through this one too. So let's say, for example, you have a TV that is, let's see what's in this list, a Hitachi. A Hitachi is TV Group B. So I'm going to link you to the PDF manual that I'm looking at, because it's got way more detailed instructions than I can give you on this YouTube video. But to do that, what you do, you'll hold down TV, and because Hitachi is in Group B, you'll hit, so once you hold down TV and it's gone steady, you're going to hit the blue B button. Once you do that, you're going to aim it and then just hit the number 2 and keep doing that until it turns off, then hit TV. It's that simple, really. And like I said, the only reason I'm doing this video is because when you look at the manual, and I'll give you a quick little look at it, yeah, this manual is ridiculous. It could be simplified. If I wrote this manual, it wouldn't look like this. And then you obviously, the last way of doing it, which is more direct, and I don't really recommend doing it this way, it's kind of a pain really, but hold down TV, then type in the code for the TV itself, then hit TV, but then you have to try it one at a time, and that's a pain. Quick setup codes, a little bit easier, but I believe that only works for the TV itself. Now, once you've set up, though, your receiver, you'll want to set up, let's say, your receiver under aux. So that way, if you hit, like, say, aux, and then volume up and down, you can control your home theater system's volume. Obviously, if you use your home theater system all the time, you kind of want that. And if you see here, the default method is if you're in cable mode, hitting the volume button controls the TV. It does not control the receiver, but there is a way to do it. Here's how that is done. So let's do this now, and I'll show it for you right here. Remember, we want cable to control aux, but it's only controlling TV. So to do this, we're going to hold down control and cable at the same time. The light is on steady. We're going to hit volume up. We're telling it we want to assign the volume keys, and then we're going to hit aux. The light will go out. So now, once we're in cable mode, if we hit volume, you see now it's controlling aux only. That means when you're controlling the cable box, hitting volume controls your home theater now. So I'm going to put it back, though, to TV because I don't have a home theater in my bedroom. And to set it back, it's really just this simple. Once again, just hit volume up, but this time we're going to hit TV. And now it goes back to controlling the TV function. Now, setting up your receiver under auxiliary is manual. It doesn't let you do... I mean, you can do this auto search function as well. The first one, holding down auxiliary and OK, going solid, and then just hitting like channel up until your stereo turns off. But you might be there for a while because there's so many different receivers. So you might want to do it manually by the make itself. But hopefully this video just clears up how to set these things up. It's a little tricky, but it's not as hard as the manual at first makes it look. Because actually, if I zoom out of the manual, this is what the manual looks like. Holy cow. That's too much. It's really not that hard. Anyway, YouTube, have a good one. I hope this video was educational for you.
Thank you for watching. And if you enjoyed this content, be sure to click like, subscribe, and if you want notifications, click that bell icon.